Hi loves, welcome back to my channel. My name is Faye and for today's video, it is a long-awaited, long-overdue SOP salary video that you guys have always asked for. So here it is. If you are interested, keep on watching. Before we get started, if you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel down below. Feel free to also turn on the bell notification so you can be notified every time I upload a new video, which is once a week. I post videos related to speech language pathology, also videos about beauty and fashion, sometimes vlog as well. If you are not new to my channel, then welcome back. Thank you so much for tuning back in. Without further ado, let's get started. The salary and how much money you make as an SOP depends on your experience, the location of your job, also the setting of your job. Any additional skill set or certifications that you have will also help increase how much money you make as well. I will also include all of the links to these statistics in the description box below if you are interested in checking them out yourself. In these official reports, there are more information that I can share in one single video. So if you are interested, feel free to check it out and read it yourself. I would say these findings are recent because it was done in 2019. Obviously, the year of 2020 isn't over yet. And given the current status of this year, everything will be a little bit different this year compared to a typical year. This year would be considered an outlier just because of this whole pandemic going on, people losing jobs or getting reduced hours. So according to ASHA, in 2019, the median annual salary for all SOPs that have answered the survey was $78,000. However, depending on the actual respective job titles, the median salary will be different. For example, the median annual salary for clinical service provider was $74,000, but for clinical supervisors and administrators was $100,000. Typically, SOPs that work in medical settings, for example, the hospitals, skilled nursing facilities, make more money than school setting SOPs, simply because medical-based SOPs work all year, but school-based SOPs only work 9 months of the year. In terms of geographic regions, SOPs in the West make more money than SOPs in the Midwest on average. In terms of years of experience, SOPs who have less than 3 years of experience make on average $66,000. Meanwhile, with 19 to 20 years of experience, they can make up to $100,000. ASHA also did a survey for people who work part-time or on an hourly pay schedule. On average, about 54% of SOPs are on an hourly pay schedule, and 60% of them work full-time. According to the ASHA survey in 2019, hourly SOPs who are part-time make about $50 an hour, and full-time SOPs who are hourly make about $42 an hour. The same trend for hourly SOPs in terms of geographic regions. SOPs who are hourly make more money in the West than in the Midwest. Next, I will be sharing with you the salary data that I've researched on Indeed.com. So according to Indeed, the median annual salary for SOPs for 2019 was $85,000. The median annual salary for SOPs for 2020 was $85,000. I collected this data in May of 2020. The next data that I will be sharing with you was from the BLS, Bureau of Labor Statistics. So according to them, in 2019, the median annual salary for SOPs was $79,000, or $38 per hour for hourly SOPs. Right now, I will be sharing with you about my personal data. I have been working in Southern California for 6 to 7 years in the pediatric private clinic setting, and I also have training in Kaufman Praxis. LSVT, which is a voice therapy treatment, mostly for Parkinson patients, but also for other types of patients that require voice treatment. I am also bilingual in Vietnamese and English, and I can speak Spanish with working proficiency. I also supervise two SOP assistants. Currently, I am working only 3 days per week. Right before this pandemic, I worked about 3 days a week in clinic, and then I write reports at home 1 day a week. So I would say my working schedule is slightly less than full-time schedule. I was and I still am on an hourly schedule. Due to the confidentiality reasons per contract with my current company, I cannot share with you the specific data of how much money I make per activity, but I can share with you that I do make money for every single treatment hour that I see client, whether in person or via telehealth services. I also make money on assessing or evaluating new patients or re-evaluating ongoing patients for progress reports. And I do get paid for evaluation report writing time and also progress report writing time. I get a block of time on a weekly basis for supervision with both of my SOP assistants, and I do get paid for that as well. I do write all of my SOP assistants' reports. Each of them oversees a full caseload of patients, so I do write a lot of reports. Not only for myself, but also for my two SOP assistants. When I was in clinic, I also get paid for administrative time, preparing for treatment, signing documents, things like that. I also get paid for every no-show, not for cancellation. And if the company hosts any meetings or any training, I will also get paid for that as well. I've been working part-time or hourly for the past 2 to 3 years, and my annual income fluctuates depending on how many hours I work per week or how many reports I write a week. But I can give you a range of how much I make. It would be within the 50 to 60K range for a part-time SOP like myself. I hope you find this video informative and helpful. Feel free to comment down below your thoughts or any questions related to the SOP field, and I will try my very best to answer every single one of your questions. Thank you so much for spending the time of your day to watch my video. If you enjoy these types of videos, feel free to give me a like down below to let me know and also to help with my channel's growth, and I will see you next time. Bye!